We are live to talk about real estate again. We are live and you are alive. It is those who are alive that go live. Is that a dilemma? This is Chidi Kalu, your real estate boy, your real estate coach. I share ideas on how to maximize real estate success. And so I am here to share opportunities and real estate investment deals with us. Today, I'm going to be discussing something very exciting, something that you will love. I'm going to be talking about raising money. Now, one of the things that a lot of us want to do is to raise money. We want to make money, you want to raise money, you want to figure out how you can build wealth. But the challenges most of us have is, how do I raise money? So I'm going to be talking about raising money for your multi-family real estate deal. How do you raise money for your multi-family real estate deal? That is one of the challenges that I actually faced when I actually wanted to get started real estate. I didn't have money, but I realized I needed to be able to raise money from people. I'm going to be sharing with us what my real estate mentor shared with me and of how to raise money in real estate. Now, what are the things he shared with me? Those things that he shared with me are the things that actually helped me to build the kind of economy that I'm currently having today. Thanks be to God and to the knowledge and the information and the wisdom that I was able to use in working. So I'm going to be sharing with you what I learned on how to raise money for multi-family apartments. What is a multi-family apartment? Multi-family apartment is multiple family apartment. That is multiple tenant apartment. Your face might face you if you have up to, let's say, about 12 units of that on a single block. It's a multi-family apartment. Your one bedroom, self-contained, two bedroom, three bedroom, as long as it is up to 12, in my own opinion, it is a multi-family apartment. If it's not a single, it is that semi-detached and all of those stuff. They are not multi-family apartment. A duplex that is, or a terrace that is up to maybe about 4 or 5, is not a multi-family apartment. They are all single family units, though they have their own range. But in my own opinion, that's my own opinion. In my own opinion, a multi-family apartment are apartments of between 12 upward. So let's get down to the business of the day. How do you raise money for a multi-family apartment? Number one thing that you must understand is this. There is money everywhere, but you need to be able to adjust your mindset to be able to build the kind of income that you want. And that is where you need to get started from. So you need, first of all, make the adjustment. Make that significant adjustment in your head, that there's money everywhere. Number one, realize this, that there's money in your space. There's money within you. There's money around you. There's money inside of you. There's money in your head. There's money outside there. Don't listen to the negative words around you that there's no money to do multifamily apartment. Get rid of the idea that there's no money. Get rid of that idea. Throw that idea into the trash can, because that is where it is. That is where it needs to be. That you need money to raise, you need to have deep pockets to be able to start real estate. I've often said this again and again. Real estate is not for the rich. Real estate is for those who want to be rich. So it is not for those who are already up there. It is for those people who want to get up there. And so that's one of the things you must understand. Real estate is not for those who have it big, who are playing the big league. You must understand this. There are a lot of people who started with 0 naira. But they're able to build sophisticated wealth because of their investment in real estate. And one of the challenges a lot of us face is because of this. And so we look at the big picture and we are consumed by the dream. We are consumed by the enormity of this monster. And before we know it, we tell ourselves that, okay, we can't do it. Yes, I have a dream, but let me be realistic. Yes, I have a dream, but let me tell you the truth. This thing is not possible in Nigeria. It can be possible in America, but it's not possible in Nigeria. But let me tell you this. You can build your own personal economy. You can build your own wealth by doing the right thing today. And that is to get rid of the idea of the mentality that there's no money in the economy. Number two is that you must understand the real estate market. Number two, understand the real estate market. you must understand how this market operates. And that's one of the things that you must understand. You must understand that we are in the renters market. We are not even in the buyers market. The buyers are less than the renters. The renters are the tenants. There are more tenants in our economy than what? Than people who buy property. And the best way for you to be able to build your own personal economy is for you to be thinking of buying up property. And so we are in the renters market. Let me tell you this, no matter how much we are able to meet the demands of housing, no matter how many houses we build, we cannot meet the demands of housing. And that's why you are beginning to see in our economy and in our space, many young people are now venturing into real estate and they are becoming instant millionaires. They are moving from zero to millions. They are moving within at a fast and speedy rate. Why? Because they understand one thing. They understand the market. They understand the property market. They understand cash flow. They understand predictability. They understand financial freedom. What people will pay for is different from what people will like to pay for. And that's one of the things when we are understanding our philosophy in doing an analysis of the market. What people will pay for in real estate is not the same thing as what people will like to pay for. What people will pay for in real estate is different from what people will like to pay for. And I will repeat it again. In real estate, what people will like to pay for. People will like to own a 7-bedroom mansion, ocean in front of it, big space, large pool, big garden, Turkish door, big stores and all of those things. People will like to have that. People will like to pay for it. But the question is, will they be able to pay for the apartment, for that kind of apartment? The question is no. There are very few people who like to pay for the dream, the house of their dream. Now, what you need to go for is not just the people's dream. What you need to go for is what? Is for the people's reality. And that is where a lot of the time people miss out on good deals. That's why you begin to wonder, why is a place in Munshin excelling in rental value than a place in Lekki and VGC? Why? Because these people, you must understand that what people will pay for is different from what people will like to pay for. And that's why sometimes some people, you may have a property in Orile and it's making more money than you, or you're enjoying more cash flow than somebody who has a property somewhere around Ikeja. Why? Because what people will like to pay for is different from what people will pay for. Now that is where you need to be able to understand how this market works. So you must understand the market. Understanding the market is very, very key. Which market do I want to operate in? Which market will I want to operate in? I want to operate, when I talk about market right now, I'm simply talking about, do I want to play the island market, island game, or do I want to play the Lekki game, the mainland game if I'm in Lagos? Do I want to play my village game, Umofia, or probably Mberofun, Ohafia, and all of those places, in Imo Owerri, and all of those places? Do I want to do deals in those places, or do I want to do deals in certain places? So where I'm going to locate my property will not determine the kind of things I'm going to set out. So what people in these areas would like to pay for is different from what they will pay for. So once you understand this, you now begin to position yourself. Number three thing that you also must consider is that you must understand the product. Now, when you look at the market, what kind of product will these people go for? What kind of product will these people like? Will they go for a 7-bedroom duplex? Or would they go for a 3-bedroom apartment? Or would they rather prefer a self-contained apartment? So once you are realizing all of this, one of the things you are now doing is that you are positioning yourself for instant wealth. Because now you cannot say, okay, you know what? These people in this place, they may like a 7-bedroom duplex, but they can only afford a self-contained. And that's where you find out in some instances where people begin to struggle for apartments. Let's say you're a developer, you are building up a structure of maybe some structure, and you just put in your banner to let 2-bedroom, 1-bedroom. You have not even finished building the apartment, but people have started rushing your agent and calling and say, I want to pick up this unit, I want to pick up this apartment. Now, what I'm simply talking about is that you have already made money before you finish the building. Do you know why? Because there is something that you understand. You understand the product. Now, a product that sells well is a product that while you are still manufacturing it, the consumers are already paying for it. That's a product that sells well. And how, what is a product that sells well? It is that it must be able to, it must be suitable for that your audience. It must be suitable for your kind of market. Now, just imagine that I go and erect a 7-bedroom duplex in Mushin. Do you think I'll be able to, I will sell faster than somebody who has a self-contained apartment in the same location? So the question now will now be, what kind of product will suit this location? What kind of apartment will suit this location? I see some people who have properties in VGC. I see some people and I just scream for them. Now, because they don't even understand how this market operates. 7-bedroom duplex, 3.5 million naira. But the question is, what if you have the same, on the same property, you have a self-contained on the same property and you can command as much as 1 million naira in VGC. And that 7-bedroom duplex that is about 3.5 million naira, if you multiply it by, if you can get 7 units of apartment on it, 7 units of apartment multiplied by 1 million naira will give you how much? 7 million naira. So you could as well as have made times 2 the double of the same amount you probably make on your 7-bedroom duplex. Now the crazy is, some people say, no, but I don't want plenty tenants. I just want a few tenants. I just want the tenant I can manage, I can handle. That is, first of all, not to disrespect you, but that is a property mentality. That is not the real mentality of a property investor. If you are going to do property investment, you must be thinking in multi, not one, not single, multi-family units. So it is property mentality to believe, to tell yourself that this thing, I only just want to just have it. Should be, it's God that will just give us. It's the average man mind that thinks that way. You need to think in terms of volume. If you are going to make any significant help in this nation, in our economy, you must be thinking of volume. Number four is that you must understand, after you've done understanding of the product, you must understand leverage. Now there's a product in your hand. You have located a product, but the question is, the topic is, I've just done all the drama, that all the things I've been saying. I know that some of you have not been paying attention. It is this one that you actually want to hear. The fourth one, and also not the most important one, but this fourth one is understanding how to use leverage. You've understood the product. You've understood, because you need to be able to understand that you must not lose people's money. That's what all the part that we've been analyzing has been talking about. But this other part is now the part of now using leverage. Now you can comfortably use leverage if you understand 1, 2, and 3. Now the fourth one, it must now be the leverage. Who is my power base? Who has my money? Who are the people in my network that I need to be able to talk with? A property is worth 50 million naira and I need to buy there's a property we are currently going for. It's worth 40 million naira somewhere around Mushin, which my team went to inspect today. It's 40 million naira, but I want to raise 70 million naira on the property. Why? Because I'm going to renovate the property. The property has about 29 units of face me, I face you. We want to convert it into self-contained. Now, what we're going to do is that we're also going to raise the money. I'm not going to use only my money because I don't have 70 million naira. I don't have it. I'm not telling you the true practical truth now. I don't have the 70 million naira, but I want to raise money from people to be able to, we'll combine resources together and we invest into that project. Why? Because the project is a clean deal. Now, this is where it gets interesting. Who's got your money? And that is why you need to check what your network is. Who is within your network? And that's why you need to change your direction. Who are the people that you need to be able to start? You need to start having conversation with. Who are the people that are in your network? Because your contacts are usually your contracts. So you need to focus on your contacts. Your contacts. If you have poor people around you, please let me tell you this. And let me tell you this. Nobody is even poor. I must tell you this. Nobody is poor. It's just that they have not come to the consciousness that there's abundance in the world and there's abundance within their space. So you must understand this part. You must clarify this part. So you must now begin to use leverage. You don't necessarily have to go it all your way. The question is, who has my money? Somebody says, how do I look for them? People who have my money. Let me tell you this. The way to look for people who have your money is number 5. To give an offer. Number 5, give an offer. Number five, to give an offer. Give an offer. Nobody rejects a sweet deal. When you come, when I come to your house, when you go to, when you go to a party, for example, and you say, and there's no one there, maybe wedding and all of that, maybe naming ceremony, and you offer people food, usually people don't reject the food. Usually. Jollof rice is very sweet. Wedding jollof rice is very sweet. So people don't reject the food. Reason is this, it's an offer. You either take it or you leave it. You're not going to kill me. So everybody may not take your offer, but if your offer is sweet enough, people will take it. People will take it. So you must give an offer. Give people an offer. Give people a good deal. Give a deal that people cannot resist, cannot reject. For example, if I'm going to do a 70 million naira, trying to raise 70 million naira, and I say, you know what, every deal, you know what, you're going to get 50%, because that's what I want to give people. I want to raise, with 5 million naira on the deal, I want to raise X amount, and I want only 14 people to be on it. So I want them to invest about 5 million naira on the deal. So this is what I want to do, is that once they raise 5 million naira, I'm going to give them 30% within 18 months. Within 18 months. And they're going to start getting, for the rest of their lives, they're going to start getting great deals. About how much is that? How much will they be getting? They'll be probably getting 10% subsequently after that year. Reason is this, for the rest of their lives. Now let me explain how this will work. The reason I'm going to do this, for the rest of their lives, they're going to be paid. That means if they're going to live for the next 40 years, they're probably going to be making 500,000 naira every year from their property investment that they made with me. That's what it means. Who will see that deal and probably want to reject it? So you must understand that you need to give people an offer. Now let me tell you this. The offer that people reject is the one that does not make them money. It's the one that does not benefit them. Once an offer is going to be beneficial to the people that you are offering it to, if they have to borrow money to invest in your deal, they will borrow money. We know that people borrow money to go play Baba Jebu, right? Yeah. Because why? Baba Jebu, there's a promise of making money. So once people can be assured that they can make money, they will go out of their way. So the reason why you are not raising money is because you cannot assure the person. So you must get to the position whereby you can assure these people. You must develop that courage, because your courage is too low. Your courage is too weak. Your courage has a shock up. Your courage is unhealthy. That is why you are not making, that's why you are not raising the money that you need. So why you are not raising? Now let your courage develop good health. Let it develop flesh. Let it develop soundness. Stop making it look as if you are a beggar. Don't be a beggar. Yes, you're going to offer a good deal, but always assure the people who you have your money. Let me tell you this. Nobody rejects a good deal. The way to make money, the way to raise money, is to help other people to make money. To show them how you can make money for them. That's the way to raise money. And so you must be able to understand how this works and position yourself for an exciting time. Try this principle and see how it works. Till I come your way again next time. Today, this is Chudi Kalu. I run seminars, I have books. Some of you, you've been listening, watching this video, you've not picked up the book. I have this book. This book will change your life, it will change how you think about real estate. I wrote this book in 6 hours. I wrote this book in 6 hours on a Sunday evening. And this is one of the best materials that I've ever written. And this is also one of the best materials that you ever read on real estate, on the subject of real estate. I can tell you, you have never seen anything like that if you are a Nigerian. I'm not even sure you have ever seen something like this if you are across any part of the world. And this one is going for free. I wrote this one and I said I'm going to distribute it for free to everyone for free. Go to www.kochudi.com. Sign up to get any of the copy of this book. And once you subscribe for this one, we're going to give you this one for free. So you subscribe for this one, we're going to give you this for free. I wrote this book and I'm excited. I'm an excited author. I'm writing another book again. Writing 3 books on real estate that will change your life. So I want you to go right now to www.kochudi.com to sign up for this great material. They're going to help you and change your perspective in real estate. Thank you very much for joining me. Till I come your way again next time, this is Chudi Kalu saying bye-bye.